फ्रेंड्स, टुडे इंशाल्लाह वी विल टॉक अबाउट महमद फातेहर सुल्तानी। हु वॉज महमद फातेहर सुल्तानी? एंड इन दिस वीडियो आई विल टेल यू डिटेल बाई डिटेल दैट हु वॉज ही एंड वट ही डिड फॉर हिज सुल्तानत। सो फ्रेंड्स, हिज फुल नेम वॉज फातेह सुल्तान महमद। ही वॉज बॉर्न इन Dogum on 29 March 1432, and after that he was the concurrent of Istanbul, 8th Ottoman Sultan, poet, born March 29, 1432, Edirne, May 3, 1481. He has used the pseudonym Evni in his poems. His father was Sultan Murad II, 7th Ottoman Sultan, and his mother was Huma Hatun. He was tall with fleshy cheeks and a curved nose. Before his ascending the throne with the name Mehmed II and between his two reigns, he served as the governor of Manisa Sanjak. He became the Padishah two times, between August 1444 and August 1446. Between May 3, 1481, he ascended the throne at the age of 24, the second time upon the death of his father. And the first thing he did was embarking on the expedition to frequently revolting Karamanoglu principality, but he forgave the apologizing Karamanoglu Ibrahim Bey. That was because Mehmed II was first of all thinking about the conquest of Istanbul. For the sake of his big goal, he was also soft on the Magyars, Serbians and Byzantines. His aim was to stop the Crusaders from uniting forces, not to provoke them and to gain time. The dwindling down Byzantine Empire, who was at the end of his 1000-year history, had become a state ruling only over Istanbul. Still, the presence of the Byzantine was posing danger with respect to the Turkish dominance in Balkans. Padishah Mehmed II started to make necessary preparations for the conquest of Istanbul. Muslihuddin Sarukash Sikban, an engineer of the period, and Magyar Urban, who took refuge in Ottoman, charged with cannon casting at Edirne. In addition to those cannons, which were called Sahi, wheel towers and chip cannon balls were also manufactured. These big cannon balls played a key role in the conquest of Istanbul. Also, Rumeli Hisari, Rumeli Fortress, Bokas Kisan, was built opposite to the Anadolu Hisari, Anatolian fortress, which was built during Yildirim Bayezid Istanbul siege. Mehmed II, who completed the preparations, took over Istanbul May 29, 1453, after about 2.5 years from the beginning of his reign, ended the East Roman Empire and moved the capital from Edirne to Istanbul. After his accomplishment, he began to be called as Fateh Sultan Mehmed. Fateh Sultan Mehmed achieved being the big commander who were praised by the Prophet Muhammad in his well-known hadith, saying, "Verily, one shall conquer Constantinople. What a wonderful leader he will be, and what a wonderful army that army will be, and known as the world emperor, closing the Middle Age and opening the New Age." Conquest of Istanbul led to very important consequences. After the conquest of Istanbul, Fateh Sultan Mehmed launched many expeditions to Europe in order to strengthen his dominance in the West, enlarging the borders and spreading Islam to the farthest places, with Serbia 1454-1459, Mauryan 1460, Valachia 1462, Moldova 1476, Bosnia-Herzegovina, Albania, Venice 1463-1479, Italy 1480, and Hungary expeditions. He strengthened the dominance in Europe of the Ottoman Empire. Fateh was also aiming to dominate the Black Sea, starting out to prevent the slave trade made by Venetians and Genoese against the Islamic world to invade the Crimea coast, where is crucial for shipping the trade goods coming to Istanbul and to make Black Sea an Ottoman lake. Fateh firstly conquered Amasra in 1459. In 1460, Kandaroglu principality was ended. On October 26, 1461, he included Trabzon in Ottoman territories and embedded Pontus Empire in history. With the invasion of Crimea in 1475, the Black Sea completely entered the domination of Ottomans. Thus, the Genoese dominance over the Black Sea ended and full control of the Silk Road passed to the Ottomans. The Kingdom of Serbia was completely dissolved and made an Ottoman Sanjak. Mauryan was completely conquered. Valachia was made an Ottoman province. Bosnia was taken under the Ottoman sovereignty again, and Albania was invaded. After Ottoman Venetian Sea Wars, which lasted for 16 years, the Venice accepted to make a peace agreement during expedition to Italy or Trento, which was a key center regarding the conquest of Rome, which was taken, but it was lost upon the sudden death of Fateh Sultan Mehmed. In the spring of 1481, he departed from Istanbul for expedition together with the army. However, he got sick because of podagra at Maltib. He couldn't progress further and died at Tikursigri Kebzi on May 3, 1481, at the age of 51. He was buried in the tomb carrying his name next to the Fateh Mosque. Fateh was very educated, very well, could speak 6 foreign languages, and was one of the great scholars of the period. He loved reading very much. He got lessons on the ancient history and had translations made. He read philological works translated into Arabic and Persian. In order to make Istanbul an important cultural center, he brought important scholars of the period, such as the big mathematician and astronomy Ali Khusru, who was the student of the Qadizade Rumi and served in the observatory of Ulug Beg. So this is how the story of Mehmed Fateh Sultani ends, my friend. And I hope you will like it. Thank you for your great time. Thank you very much.